Hello, let's discuss the test prototypes today. A prototype is primarily a vehicle for exploration, communication, and evaluation. Its purpose is to obtain a user input in design and to provide feedback to designers. Its major function is the communicative role it plays, not accuracy or thoroughness. A prototype enables a design to be better visualized and provides insights into how the software will look and work. And it also aids in the defining task, their flow, the interface itself, and its screens. A prototype is a simulation of an actual system that can be quickly created. A prototype may be rough. A prototype may be a rough approximation, such as a simple hand-drawn sketch, or it may be interactive, allowing the user to key or select data using controls, navigate through menus, retrieve displays of data, and perform basic system functions. A prototype need not be perfectly realistic, but it must be reasonably accurate and legible. A prototype also need to be functionally complete, possessing actual files or possessing processing data. Okay. Today, many software support tools for prototyping are available that permit the prototype to be integrated and directly into the application code. A prototype may have greater breadth, including as many features as possible to present concepts and overall organization, or it might have more depth, including more detail on a given feature or task to focus on individual design aspects. By nature, a prototype cannot be used to exercise all of a system's functions, just those that are notable in one manner or another. Particularly useful early in design, a prototype should be capable of being rapidly changed as a testing is performed. A prototype is characterized by its fidelity, that exactness and thoroughness of its replication of a system screens and user interaction. Prototypes range in fidelity from low to high, from rough hand-drawn sketches to fully functioning software. Okay. Various kinds of prototypes existed. In general, order of increased fidelity are as follows. First one is hand sketches and scenarios. Description: a screen sketch is created by hand. Focus is on the design, not the interface mechanics. A low fidelity prototype. Okay, hand sketch is the low fidelity prototype. Advantages of hand sketches are: can be used very early in the development process, suited for use by entire design team, no large investment of time and cost, no programming skill is needed, easily portable, fast to modify and iterate, a rough approximation often yields more substantive critical comments, easier to comprehend than functional specification, can be used to redefine requirements. The disadvantages: only a rough approximation, limited in providing understanding of navigation and flow, demonstration not an exercise, okay, driven by facilitator not the user, limited usefulness for a usability test, a poor detailed specification for writing the code, usually restricted to most common tasks are the disadvantages. Here is the description in detail. The first and simplest prototype is a low fidelity rough hand-drawn sketch or mock-up of the screens. These can start early in the design process and before any attempt is made to create a prototype using an available toolkit or interface builder. With sketches, the focus is on the design of individual screens, not the interface mechanics. The hand sketch should be an entity that has enough of a general look to suggest the functionality, interaction, and layout of screens. The goal is a rough vision, not a polished work of art. This sketch will be useful in defining and refining task organization, conceptual ideas, and the general layouts of a screen. Here are some advantages. Hand-drawn sketches of screens can be easily developed and used very early in the development process. Many usability problems can then be identified and corrected quickly. Sketches are also suitable for use by the entire development team, giving everyone a sense of what the real design issues are. Sketches require no large investment of time and money. They are portable, placing few restrictions on where the testing may occur. Sketches can also be quickly modified and iterated as many times as necessary, because there has been no emotional investment in the investment in the code and the status quo. There is no necessity for team members to defend something already created from hard work. Screen sketches are rough approximations, and rough approximations often yield more substantive suggestions or critical comments than actual screen drawn versions. Their draft or unpolished look greatly softens the attitude that everything is cast in concrete. Sketches can also be used to define a system's requirement. Disadvantages are, since hand-drawn sketches are rough approximations, they can only suggest the final layout of the interface. They are limited in helping understand system navigation and flow, and are a demonstration device driven by a facilitator with the user assuming more passive role. They are usually restricted to the most common user task. As a result, they possess limited usefulness for usability testing. Now let's discuss the sketch creation process. Sketch, a storyboard, and the screen while determining. Okay, sketch the screens while determining the source of the screen information, the content and structure of individual screens, the overall order of screens and windows, use an erasable medium. Sketch the screens needed to complete each workflow task. Try out selected metaphor and choose them as necessary. First, storyboard common critical frequent scenarios. Follow them from beginning to end, then go back and build in exceptions. Don't get too detailed. Exact control positioning is not important, just overall order and flow. Storyboard as a team, including at least one user. Only develop online prototypes when everyone agrees that a complete set of screen has been satisfactorily sketched. Sketch that screens while determining the source of the screen's information, the content and structure of individual screens, and the overall flow of the screens. Use an erasable medium so that as ideas are explored and changed, the modifications will be easy to make. Sketch the screens needed to complete each task in the workflow. First, sketch the most common critical or frequent activities, following them from beginning to end. Then go back and build in the exceptions. Try out all the selected metaphors and modify them as necessary. Make sure the major user objects are very obvious. Avoid getting too detailed. Most important is the overall screen flow, order and structure. Approximate the positioning of control simply to verify fit. Exact positioning will come later. Sketch the screen as a team, including at least one user, to avoid solidifying the product too soon. Develop online prototypes only when everyone agrees a complete set of screens have been satisfactorily sketched. Okay. Now let's discuss interactive paper prototypes. Interface components, menus, windows and screen constructed for of common paper technologies, post-it notes, transparencies and so on. The components are manually manipulated to reflect the dynamics of the software. Low fidelity prototype. This one is low fidelity prototype. Advantages: more illustrative or program dynamics than sketches, can be used to demonstrate the interaction. Otherwise, generally the same as for hand-drawn sketches and scenarios. Disadvantages: only a rough approximation, a demonstration, not an exercise, driven by facilitator, not the user. Limited usefulness for usability testing. Here is a description in detail. Another simple low fidelity prototype involves use of a common office supply such as post-it notes, transparencies, markers and scissors. Menu bars, pull-downs, menus, pop-up windows, screen bodies and so on reflecting system tasks are created using these media. Then the components are manually manipulated to illustrate the dynamics of the software. The purpose of this kind of prototype is to provide a sense of the dynamics of a program without actually having to build a functional version of it. The objective again is to create a rough vision, not a polished piece of art, in order to elicit substantive suggestions and critical comments. The goal is not to show how the system or website will look, but to assess if people can easily use it. Advantages of interactive paper prototypes are, interactive paper prototypes are more illustrative of program dynamics than simple screen sketches. Simple components can be manipulated to demonstrate the interactive nature of the system. The other paper prototype's advantages are generally the same as those described for hand-drawn sketches and scenarios. Disadvantages are similar to those for hand-drawn sketches. They are only rough approximations or demonstrations and not exercises, are driven by a facilitator, not the user, and possess limited usefulness for usability testing. Now let's discuss programmed facets descriptions. Examples of finished dialogues and screen for some important aspects of the system. Created by prototyping tools, medium fidelity to high fidelity prototypes. Advantages are provide a good detailed specification for writing code, a vehicle for data collection. Disadvantages of programmed facets may solidify the design too soon, may create the false expectation that the real thing is only a short time away, more expensive to develop, more time consuming to create, not effective for requirements gathering. Not all of the functions demonstrated may be used because of cost, schedule limitations or lack of user interest. Not practical for investigating more than two or three approaches. Description in detail is to provide a realistic surface view of a real program and to illustrate some of the program's functioning, a programmed facet can be created. Using prototyping tools such as HyperCard, SuperCard and Toolbox, examples of finished dialogues and screens for some important aspects of the system are constructed and viewed. The facet is very shallow, duplicating only a small portion of what is ultimately intended in both depth and breadth. Because of this shallow nature, it is best described as a medium fidelity to high fidelity prototype. Advantage of program facets: while much is missing underneath, what is visible can provide a good impression of finished design. Programmed facets also provide a good detailed specification for writing code, can be a vehicle for the actual collection of data. Disadvantages of program facets: first, a highly polished product can foster a sense of finality because of its appearance. Significant organization, reorganization or restructuring suggestions may be inhibited. With the tools, with the focus simply being on screen cosmetics. Second, the false expectation that the real thing is only a short time away may easily be created. Even though much work still remains to be done, programmed facets are also much more expensive to develop than paper-based prototypes, and they take much longer to create also. Not all of the functions demonstrated may eventually be used because of cost, schedule limitations or lack of user interest, and they are not practical for investigating more than two or three alternate design approaches. Prototype oriented languages, one more prototype test. Description: an example of, here is the description, we discussed that. To present an example, what is that? Finished dialogues and screens for some important aspects of the system, created through programming languages that support the actual programming process. A high fidelity prototype. Advantages are may include the final code, otherwise generally the same as those of program facet. Disadvantages: generally the same as for program facets. Here is a description in detail. To present an example of a complete dialogues and screen for some part of the system, prototypes can be constructed using programmed languages that support the actual programming process. Examples include Power Builder, Visual Basic and so on. Using these tools, a high fidelity real program can be created to illustrate some of the program functioning and the mechanics of the interface. One consideration to be decided upfront: will the prototype software be a throwaway or the actual system software? This will have implications concerning the amount of programming effort expended on the prototype. Advantages are, the greatest advantage of this kind of prototype is that it may include the actual code needed for the system. Otherwise, advantages are generally the same as those of programmed facets. Disadvantages are, like a programmed facets, a danger is that the highly polished product can foster a sense of finality because of its appearance, inhibiting reorganization, restructuring suggestions, the focus simply being on screen cosmetics. Other disadvantages are also similar to those of programming facets. Thank you for watching.